Okay, let's try. This is a big log challenge. So, got a little bit of log tong deadlift practice here today. Too bad. Size. So on the smaller side here, she is about 17. About 18 and a half. So then that widens out to, at the widest point here, about 24 ish inches. And then over on this side, it's just three trunks there. So I got a bigger section of it over there that's just still standing. I was thinking about trying to fell that first for a big log, but I might have to use the chainsaw just to get it down to the stump. It's technically at the corner of mine and my neighbor's property. So that big bohonkus over there. But we'll try a little bit of bigger log bucking practice today anyhow. Pause this. The axes I have out today are gonna be the Mapsist Forge finish pattern there. That's on about that 32 inch handle. Through shear, it's pretty thick, but I think traditionally these finish heads with the smaller top and down, they're relatively thick, but thinned it out down towards the hand, and that seems to not do too bad. The hickory, it does get a little bit of shock in the hands, but it seems to do really well overall. And the 36 inch Kelly jersey, I think overall it's about 4 pounds with the handle. I think it's a 3.5 pound head. It's been a while since I weighed it, just the head there. But see how that does. These jerseys are pretty thin overall. Let's see if we can get that to focus here. It's not going to undo it, but that is just on the, it's that True Temper, Kelly. And then the Basque 175 on the 75 centimeter handle. It's about, I think, 30, 32 inches, all said and done. But, all right, I'm gonna chop out a couple footholds so I don't slip, because this black stuff here is like frickin' grease. But, all right, let's get that set up. You guys don't need to see me do all that. Okay, got some foot places hacked out. Kind of generally put a notch in there. I come out just a little bit further with that. But we're gonna go try to go right over. That's kind of not the widest point, but almost there. Just because that other stump is, that limb is coming out that side. But kind of get the X kind of coming here. And over towards this side there. This won't probably come out just a hair here. Go out just a little bit more with that one. Change that just a hair. Start off with the Basque on the top, and we'll move to either the finish or the True Temper for the bottom of the cut. At least that's the plan, so let's get after it. to it here. There it is. chip does not want to come out. Side one. All right. Caught my breath for a minute or so there. I may have to adjust my cut over just a little bit with this backside, but that chip did not want to come out in the bottom. It's kind of stringy for whatever reason, but the 36-inch handle definitely was awesome in the bottom of that notch there. So, all right, let's see if I can get you guys set up on this other side, although I'm in the frickin' weeds here for the other side, and I don't feel like shifting the log right now. But, all right, let's see if we can get you set up. All right, see how this angle goes. Get the brick set here. Gonna be the finished pattern here. Thank you. knot right up here at the top, making life a little more difficult. Chips. the basque and see if this is any better here. To the 36 inch. Oh, I'm gonna have to go in soon. Pretty quick here, the little one's waking up.
Oh.
Oh, that in the middle is hard. All right, that there, got the V. Some decent sized chunks out here today. Oh, got the True Temper jersey, the Finish, and the Basque. The Finish one was quite a bit more sticky in the cut, which tired me out pretty quick. It just wasn't biting as much and not popping out those chips for some reason. Still like the Axe, but my little one's waking up, so I'm gonna go attend to her and probably eat some lunch here. All right, you guys have a good one.